My name is Chris Verbiski, owner of Atlantic Rivers and Loop. Atlantic Rivers is based in Labrador, two lodges in Labrador, and Loop is based out of Sweden, which is a fly fishing tackle company. First camp was built here in 1964. It went for sale in 2010. We purchased it in the fall of 2010. If you were to put one thing on the Hunt River, it would be serenity. It's a very gently flowing river, easy passage via river canoes, clear water. You can spot all the fish as you traverse the river. In 2011, our first season of operations, we had 243 salmon released for the year. So we were shocked at how few fish that were in the river system at that time. So we immediately instituted catch and release. Well, this season we'll be over 1,100 salmon released. When we first began the concept of engaging science on the rivers, the first people we went to were the Department of Fisheries and Oceans.
I'm Martha Robertson. I'm a research scientist with Fisheries and Oceans Canada in St. John's, and I research Atlantic salmon. So in Newfoundland and Labrador, we actually have the majority of Atlantic salmon in eastern North America. So the population of small and large salmon here represents most of the salmon that are actually produced in North America in the rivers.
We wanted to know where the salmon spawn, the times that they enter the river, the times they depart the river, the actual spawning beds, the intra-river movements.
So we are looking at using radio telemetry and acoustic telemetry, which is tagging fish with electronic tags, and we're able to follow them through the river and as they migrate out into the ocean, trying to keep these populations healthy. So if we notice anything, you know, fisheries management could make decisions to sort of change bag limits or have a catch and release only fishery so we can maintain the healthy populations.
Catch and release is beyond antidotal. Our logbook clearly indicates that our numbers have increased, but also the size of the fish has increased. Our 10 to 19 pound class have gone exponential. They've gone from 34 salmon in 2011, and the 10 to 19 pound class will be over 200 this year. So 25% of the population is big fish now.
Hello, my name's Ian Fairgreave, and I'm a full-time spey cast instructor, but also very fortunate to be one of the Loop Tackle Development Consultants. So I help Loop as a brand develop specific products for various applications in the fly fishing market. It actually is great to come to places in the world where it is so remote that there is no road traffic access, and you have to use the facility of a helicopter to fly in to get to remote areas to experience amazing fishing.
I'm Thomas, and I work for Loop Tackle Design as a product designer. I started fishing when I was very, very young, and I was like the age of like 5 years maybe. My father and my grandfather always took me out to trips. We were fishing for pike and perch and all kind of stuff. I would say the differences between the rivers here in Canada and Sweden, the water is very clear here, and it's not very deep rivers here compared to what we have back home. The salmon here are very willing to take the bomber up in the surface, and the action is like unbelievable. It's beyond anything. I love it.
Good job, man.
I got a fantastic song for the day. Just fishing for like 5 minutes,
yeah,
and up it just came, boom, took the bomber. Perfect day.
Back home, I have two of my very good friends, Lars Munk and Ronald Lundin. They work up north in Sweden. They have like huge rivers, not rivers like this. People like them we can use when we develop our 15-foot rods, our long spey heads, because they are like world champions in fly casting. They have all this kind of certifications when it comes to fly casting. So we use those guys a lot.
We're in such a wonderful place with fly fishing as it is just now, because we're empowering youngsters to go out into huge range of environments and collect media and put together these tremendous fly fishing films, which then promote it to other youngsters. So that helps encourage more youngsters into the sport.
Experience for most people at the Hunt River would be the fish you caught or the fish you lost.
Put a fly tag in the nice salmon that Fred got. He's about 15 pounds, 85 centimeters. Fred's fish is gonna be AR 3200.
There he is.
Okay, buddy.
Ça sera pas de la science-fiction. Si le monde il s'imagine que j'ai déjà pris un gros saumon, là, il est tagué puis il est enregistré.
Good job, man.
Sitting in the back seat of your mother's car, there was forests on the way that you ran all the way that sent some complex signals to the others on the road. I was sending all the mind beams, no one ever found me. Is there a world for things we had in the day? Is there a sound of the things we found on our way? Calling out the names of all the animals. There were mountains on the way that you read all the way that numbers getting smaller and the spirits getting low. I was sending all the mind beams, no one ever found me.
So we'll send these scales back to DFO and they'll determine and tell us exactly how old the fish is and its whole life cycle, when it departed as a spolt, when it came back to the river first, or if in fact this may be its first time as a, is that a 14 pounder?
So we collect scale samples on salmon, and you can actually look at the scale. It's kind of like a tree, like the way the tree grows. It has rings, and if it grows more, you know, the ring is more spaced apart. Well, so the scale that you looked at today from Hunt River, you could tell that it was a grilse, which meant that when it first came back to spawn, It was 1 year, so it left as a young fish. It spent one full year at sea. It came back to river to spawn. Some fish will just return to sea for the summer and then come back the next fall. So they might leave in, you know, May or June and come back in August and spawn again the following year. We call those consecutive spawners. But then the fish that you brought in was a grilse. It had spawned, but then it actually went to sea for one complete year. So it actually skipped to the next spawning. We call those alternate spawners. So once that fish went out and fed for another year, that's one way to get really big. The longer you spend at sea feeding, the bigger you get. I was sending all the mind beams, no one ever found me.
Is there a word for things we heard in the day? Is there a sound for the thing we found on our way?
So I think the ultimate point is that an ecosystem such as the Hunt River can recover when given the opportunity. And I think this can be a template for many rivers, whether it be on this side of the Atlantic or the other side. So Char Lake is just 15 kilometers to the north. We have a lease over there. Certain groups choose to go over there and look for a diversion away from the salmon for an afternoon. It's a special experience over there. You're casting into hundreds of char.
Yeah, we just landed in Char Lake, the whole team, and we look forward to a fantastic day with some nice sea-run char here.
The place is just bouncing full of fish. It's a wonderful day. It's an amazing environment. Can only be good times ahead here. Wherever there's fire, someone will always want more.
Yeah, good one, bro. Wow.
Wherever there's a fire, there's a light. That shines so bright. Wherever there's fire, there's warmth to hold you tight. Who's that dog? Oh, knocking on my door. Wherever there's fire.
Yeah, I think by virtue of its isolation, there's still plenty of fishing to be discovered here. And you know, you can expand that out beyond this river. Labrador still has some of the best fishing on the planet.
The most special thing with fly fishing is not catching as many fish as you can. It's more than that. It's like meeting friends, be a part of the nature, to be out in the nature. It's very, very important for me.
Get a group of anglers together like we've got here. We have Scottish anglers, we have Scandinavian anglers, we have French anglers, we have Canadian anglers. And the buzz and the camaraderie in the group is just amazing. We share a common love.
If I could bring it down to one word, it's family. It doesn't matter where you travel in the world. It's a brotherhood.